Hello everyone, Equipment War here, and welcome to my fast build guide for my Fire Witch. I'm gonna do the usual, I'm gonna go over my gear and my skill tree, and the gems I'm using, and then I'm going to play this Scorch map here. Just to show off build, it's not a really hard map, but it is a fun map, so I'm gonna play that. So, let's get started by taking a look at my passive skill tree. If you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comments. So I went for the spell damage in the beginning, Occultist Dominion, Firewalker, Deep Thoughts, Cool Perception, Heart of Flame, and then Mental Rapidity. I went for Quick Recovery because I want as much life end as possible, and the mana regeneration is also really nice because your skill is very mana hungry. I went for Purity of Flesh, Light of Divinity to get more damage, Elementalist, more damage, and Element Resistance, Discipline Training, Retribution, Rightness Decree, Sentry, more life and mana regeneration, Combat Stamina. I also went for an Yule here, which are Assassin's Haste. I went for Shaper, Life Generation, a rare Yule, which give you cost speed and some mana. I have the huge life wheel here. I have Arcanist, which give you really good amount of fire damage and give you life regeneration. I also have Barbarism to get increased maximum fire resist. Also give you fire resist and some life. I also have Survival Secrets, which give you increased mana regeneration and even some elemental damage. I have Juggernaut, Home Mastery for survivability, Diamond Skin, Heart of the Warrior, and Life Regeneration. And then I also have Unraveling Stance, which are really important in Incinerator build, just so you can't get stunned and interrupt your casting. So this is pretty much how my passive skill tree look like. If you have any questions about my passive skill tree, feel free to ask me in the comments. So let's take a quick look at my the gear I'm using, and I'm going to have a link in the description where you can see all of my gear and gems. First off, I'm using Consuming Dark. You don't have to use Consuming Dark. The reason I'm using Consuming Dark is it convert 35% of your fire damage into chaos damage. It will bypass enemy's fire resist. It also can't be reflected. If you don't have Consuming Dark or don't want to use it, you can use a rare wand like this one, which gives you as high cast speed and spell damage as possible. I just have a normal, really defensive helmet with life and the resistance and as high armor as possible, and that's pretty much go for my boots as well, as high life and armor as possible, and try to get some movement speed as well. I have my amulet, which give me the same thing as my helmet, as high life and resistance you might need. Also, doesn't hurt if you can get some spell cast speed or spell damage on it as well. Same thing with rings, try to get some cast speed on them if you can. I don't have it. But again, try to get as high life and resistance you need. And same thing with another ring. For shield, I'm using Rise of the Phoenix. This is just a reskin, but this is a unique shield called Rise of the Phoenix. You can see it on how it actually looks like on screen right now. And that shield is really crucial because it increases your maximum fire resist by 8. It means that you can much more easily sustain your brightness fire. I also have a Belly of the Beast armor. Again, it's just it doesn't look like this. You can see it on screen right now. I have it mainly for it have very good defense and it give you a huge amount of life. So it's a really powerful armor. And finally, my gauntlets, which are Wings of Change, which increase your projectile speed and which are really helpful, and it means you can hit enemy further away, and also increase your projectile damage and knock back enemy, which means if the enemy getting too close to you, you can just knock back them back. And finally, I have a leather belt, which increases my life and the resistance I might need, and that's pretty much my gear. When it comes to my gems I'm using, my main setup for damage, which are incinerate. It is incinerate supported by greater multiple projectiles, Life Leech support gem, faster casting, and Iron Wheel support gem. I also have a I also have a flame totem, which are only supported by faster casting and elemental focus. I'm using a teleport setup, which are lightning warp, which are supported by less duration and faster casting. The auras I'm using, purity of fire, vitality, and clarity to get more mana back. And then my Raiden's Fire are not supported by anything. So that's pretty much the setup and skills I'm using this character. And again, if you have any questions or if something I missed, feel free to ask me in the comments. And by the way, before I forgot it, the bandits I helped and killed, in normal I helped the orc to get more life. In cruel, I helped Alira to get more cast speed. And in merciless, I just killed all of them. So let's try out this build here and let's use this Cinder Edge map. It's not the highest map possible, but it is still a pretty fun map to play, and it's pretty high map. It was the highest I happened to have. Oh, and before I forget it, which I actually did, the one I ascended as a elementalist, and I just took the elemental damage. I went for a Paragram of Calamity, which are pretty nice. Pendulum of Destruction, and I have more elemental damage. It's not the most optimized character you can play this build as, but it was the best choice for a witch. So, let's see if we can kill some enemies. And I'm going to use both the Consuming Dark and the other one. As you can see, holy shit, I just find my Qun map. That's pretty awesome, actually. And the reason I'm taking damage when I'm standing in this lightning area is because it increases the damage I take from... holy shit. It increases the damage I will take from my Raiden's Fire. And this character can do a Seer as well. I'm pretty much halfway through this map. I'm going to change to my other wand, and let's see how that turns out. As you can see, it does really good damage, and it seems to have been nerfed quite a lot, actually. But it's still a decent, powerful skill, and it will still wreck most things you fight, and it's actually pretty decent, especially against the melee characters in PvP. It also nerfed Consuming Dark. As you can see, you pretty much one-shot most things. It's a very easy build to level up as well. You can, as soon as you get the Incinerate, you can just start leveling with that, and you don't have to do anything else. You don't have to use another skill when you're leveling up. Also, I also forgot, I actually have a Fireball as well. I'm using my Flame Totem to attack enemies I don't want to stand to steal in front of. Let's say I'm fighting Atsiri, and I want to fight Atsiri, but I want to get away from dangerous effects. I just place a Flame Totem here and let the Flame Totem attack Atsiri when I'm busy doing something else. And also a really good way to increase your damage. Because Flame Totem, you should not underestimate that. So let's change to our other one and see how that turns out. Just don't want to stand in the hot ground, because it makes me take damage, and I don't like taking damage. So let's change our setup to the one that's there, which increases our cast speed. And you can see, even with this pretty cheap one, actually, I think it cost like 2 chaos or not even that. It was very, very cheap, and you can still see it does a lot of damage. As you can see, this character is a decent tanky character as well. They are an extra damage mod on this map, so you don't have to be that afraid of getting one shot with this character. And by the way, one important thing with this build, try to get as small amount of energy shield as possible. Energy shield only destroys for you if you have this when you're playing this build, so try to get as small amount of energy shield as possible. It is unavoidable to get energy shield because of your shield, the shield you're using. But try to get as small amount as possible and don't have too much intelligence. Just take the smallest amount of intelligence you can possibly have to still use your build. What's that, an empower gem? Holy shit, it's pretty nice. And speaking of empower, you can actually use empower on this build. It will work just fantastic to have on your main damage setup. By the way, one of the comments on my old incinerate build, actually wondering how they're gonna use consuming dark when they don't have a legacy one. Legacy consuming dark do not exist anymore. And here we have the boss. Also, Blade can hit pretty hard. But not hard enough. And there we go, we just clear a gorge map. If you have any questions about the build or the gameplay, feel free to ask in the comments. And also, I hope you guys like this a little bit shorter, how I do my build guides. I'm not going to do all my build guides like this. But if I'm doing a build guide for a build which have changed just a little bit from the original, I'm just doing a faster, not as detailed build guide for them. But anyway, I hope you guys like it, and I'll be happy to see you soon. See you guys next time.